the Channel Islands National Park lies off the coast of California. They make up a biome containing a diverse group of marine, plant, and animal life, many of which have yet to be discovered.
What is also intriguing is what surrounds the islands, the Channel Islands National Marine Sanctuary. And with only 5% of the Earth's oceans mapped, there's still a lot left to be discovered.
Maybe that's why people, like Chris Mobley, love to come to work every day. Mobley, the Channel Islands National Marine Sanctuary superintendent, works with the government to manage the National Marine Sanctuary, which extends from the shoreline out to 6 nautical miles offshore.
Well, it's an incredibly unique spot with super high biodiversity, super high productivity. So for example, you can find species from all over the world coming to feed here and raise their young. And it has some of the richest fishing grounds in all of California as well. So some people call it the Galapagos of North America.
The Nautilus, an exploration vessel that is operated by the Ocean Exploration Trust, brought students and educators of all ages to learn more about what resides in the depths of our oceans. One of its goals was to map the Channel Islands National Marine Sanctuary using the underwater remotely operated vehicle, ROV Hercules, which can descend to a depth of 1,600 to 1,900 meters in 30 minutes. During its 2016 expedition, they observed and recorded many species, including starfish, skates, a googly-eyed squid, and something which even amused and baffled them.
It's purple blob. Great mind.
Purple blob.
Blob is purplish.
It has the...
What is that?
I actually have no idea
what that is.
Julie Bursek is a science team lead who works with NOAA, the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration, in the Channel Islands National Marine Sanctuary. She was one of the scientists on watch during the discovery of the purple blob.
At first glance, when we saw it, it looked perfectly spherical, almost like a super ball or a disco ball. It had quite a few terms of endearment that were assigned to it. And what was interesting about it, we ended up slurping it into the slurp gun, which is on the front of the Hercules. And what the hose does, it takes it and puts it back in a sample jar. We went into the wet lab to retrieve the sample, and it looked completely different. And that was our first clue that this round ball that was purple was actually maybe a type of a gastropod, a snail. We saw the muscular foot, we saw 2 antennae, and the ball had kind of, here's the ball, it kind of opened up into 2 lobes with the foot in the middle. And so those 2 lobes were probably the breathing structures, the gills. But everybody was still stumped.
The blob is currently being studied at the Harvard Museum of Comparative Zoology. Identifying whether or not the blob is a new species may take several years. Mobley says that discoveries like this one help us learn what goes on in our oceans.
Discovery is important for a lot of reasons. It's exciting, it's fun, especially for STEM education. But if you could go on an expedition like this and discover a new species or see incredible habitats you've never been able to see in your life, and then you have to use engineering skills, math skills, computer skills, science skills to collect the data, you're learning science on the job, and it's a lot more interesting than reading it from a dry, dusty textbook. But the Nautilus is unique because the vast majority of the people on board are students or younger scientists, and so the ship, while it's doing incredible cutting-edge science, most of that science is being done by either young graduate students or some undergraduates and folks like that. So it's really exciting to be on a ship like that.
Wait for it.
We're waiting.
Where is it? Sediment.
Bay! There it goes.
Yeah.